Hello everybody, today I have a look at two spider coats with stainless steel handles. That's exactly a kind of handle material that is not used very often at spider coat. Well, some of their models, they derive a stainless steel handle version of it, but there are only a few knives which out of the box you could say were designed for stainless steel handles, because it's a bit, these days a bit regarded as a somewhat old fashioned handle material because it's a bit heavier. And it's definitely a bit colder to the touch in a cold environment compared to the more modern materials like G10 and carbon fiber. And it doesn't have that old world charm of wood or bone inlays either. So it is a bit an offbeat kind of handle material in today's world, but there are definitely people who like stainless steel handles because it is true, they give a solid feeling while not adding to the price as a titanium handle would. And more traditional users, they like a bit the feel of a hefty knife, which you of course almost automatically get with stainless steel. Two quite particular designs, not in production anymore, but if you look around you should still be able to find them at a good price, but they are not yet really collectible. This one is the Scorpius, designed by Erik Glesser, son of founder Spyder co-founder Stahl Glesser, and also proficient knife designer. The name Scorpius comes from this particular tail part here, which is quite sturdy actually. I don't know why this is. I think it's just maybe there's a tactical usage for this. Well, I don't know. But it definitely adds to a somewhat longer handle, which is good for gripping. And there's nothing to adjust here. So you see here the handle is plain slab of metal at the two sides. You notice here the E, that's the signature of the designer. You can put the clip in the two ways. It has a backlock, but there's nothing to adjust. You see there are no screws. So, but then again, this kind of knife should normally give you plenty of service before something would need adjustments, which you cannot do. Now, in contrast, this other one was designed by a Spyderco forum user with the username Dialex. And he designed this wild looking Spyderco called the Adventura. Very different from most Spyderco's, which are Spyderco tends to be very much no-nonsense and almost plain looking, except for that strange hole. Well, some people find it strange. And so this one looks a bit wilder. Now, you have all those little openings everywhere, which will reduce the weight somewhat. And indeed, it's a bit lighter than the Scorpius, which is around, I think, around 130 grams, and this is around 120 grams or so. So it's indeed a bit lighter. This one also has another particularity. It is one of the very few Spyderco's with a recurve blade, as you can see. Most spider cores have indeed a simple curve. They often have a leaf kind of blade. Well, this one is not exactly a leaf shape, but the bottom, the cutting edge is typically has this kind of format spider core. This is one of the few with a recurve. Now, this bit of extra belly here at the tip helps for good cutting. Otherwise, I'm not so in fan of recurves. Now, both are backlocks made in Seki City, like many spider consoles, so you know they are really well made non-nonsense knife. And you, when I say Seki City, then you know that indeed the steel most likely, such as here, is a VG10, a really good Japanese steel that actually, well, is pretty sharpenable by yourself if you keep it in a good shape with your sharp maker, and keeps a really good edge and is reasonably stainless, so it's a really pretty good steel. The blade length of both is more or less the same, so which is here at the top 8.5 centimeter, say 3.5 inches, but you have this ricasso here, this first part, which is also where you put your finger of around a good centimeter, which anyway you have around 7 centimeters, a bit less than 3 inches cutting edge. And here the other one has, well, it also depends a bit where you measure, around 8 centimeters, a bit less actually than here. a good 3 inches long, the blade, and the cutting edge is around 6.5 centimeters, which you could say is 2.5 inches roughly. So it's a bit less cutting edge, but probably a more general form, because this recurve is, well, I never was such a fan of it, while it looks pretty funky, of course. Also particular of these two is that they have here this top part of the blade, which looks a bit dagger-like, but it's a false edge. Both of them have this feature. So, yes, if you like stainless steel material, well, both are pretty interesting. I will close them now. So, sturdy backlocks actually, no play on them. Blade around 3 mm, typical spider coat thickness. What you also have stainless steel handled or bolstered spider coat is that this one opens a bit heavier. But okay, it's perfectly acceptable. And here the somewhat nimbler Adventura, which despite its wild looks is actually pretty, really very good in the hand. And it doesn't feel so heavy at all. So again, very nicely made. And again, somewhat stiffer to open than many other spider coats. The handles are a bit stronger together. You notice here all the screws. You can open this one should you want to. Now, typically with backlocks, the only thing that you need to service is here, that you need to clean this out if there is dirt coming in that part here, because then the locking doesn't go so well anymore. Although normally it won't ever need to be opened, so that's why I wouldn't worry too much that this one doesn't have screws. And notice here in the hand indeed this scorpion tail like part, that indeed it gives you some extra margin for your hand. So it is pretty good in the hand, but actually, the Adventura is better in the hand. It looks unlike any other spider coat, but is quite a fun companion knife for general outdoor use. So it feels pretty good. The deeper coil here makes that your finger doesn't slip on the blade. Very heavy jimping here for really a precise grip. Should you really want to, if you need to precisely cut sideways, these little holes here and this thin part help a bit with. For a close grip, that can possibly be useful. The clip you can put in the four places.